Aslam Alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulullah. Maintaining the salah. What defines you as a Muslim is your salah. La faruqa bayna al-Muslim wa al-Kafir illa bi-salah. What differentiates you from a Kafir is your salah. As-salah is the second pillar of Islam, yet it is the utmost bedrock of Islam. It is necessary upon you. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, He said that, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِزُونَ And those who strictly guard their salah, أُولَٰئِكَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ مُكْرَمُونَ They will be in the gardens honored. If you want to be among the people of Jannat al-Firdaus, salah is necessary upon you. If you want to be among those who are praised by Allah, salah is necessary upon you. Do you want to be honored by Allah and in the Jannah? Then salah is necessary upon you. And then if you want to leave sins and disobedience, then salah is necessary upon you. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَىٰ عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ Indeed, salah prohibits from immorality and evil. وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ And the remembrance of Allah is greater. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَصْنَعُونَ And Allah knows what you do. Salah is the foundation of your religion, al-Islam. Praying five times daily is the absolute must. Without it, you will never improve your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nor will anything you do implement in your life be of any benefit. The first thing to be accounted for on the day of Qiyamah is Salah. Without the Salah, all other good deeds will be turned to dust. Such a strong emphasis is laid upon Salah that whoever stands the Salah, whoever prays the Salah, verily such a person has upholded Islam. But whoever leaves Salah has definitely dropped Islam. Imam Bunu Hanifa, rahimahullah alayhi, would always say that the person who leaves Salah should be imprisoned. Bunu Al-Qayyim, rahimahullah alayhi, wrote that leaving the Salah is worse than murder. So let us not leave Salah but increasing it, increasing our nawafil and sunnah Salah, and adorn ourselves with the light of ibadah. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith quoting that Allahu Azza wa Jalla says, and my servant does not draw near to me with anything more beloved to me than the religious duties I have obligated upon him. And my servant continues to draw near to me with nawafil until I love him. When I love him, I become his hearing with which he hears. I become his sight with which he sees, and become his hand with which he strikes, and become his foot with which he walks. Then Allah loves them. And then will anyone sin as they used to when their senses are now in tune with taqwa? No. But it all stems from Salah. So ask yourself, are you praying your Salah at all? Are you completing your five daily Salah and are you trying to improve on each and every one of your Salahs? I hope you are not the guy or the lady that just prays some and then neglect the rest. But know something, Salah is the only ibadah in Islam that the Prophet Muhammad went to collect from Allah on the seventh heaven during the Isra and Mi'raj traveling. This shows how important the Salah is. So make the effort to complete your Salah every day. May Almighty Allah make us among those who guard their Salah. Ameen ya Rabbana Alameen. Ma salam.